So next step, separate the terms. You get integration of 1 minus x square plus x raised to 4 upon 1 plus x square into 1 minus x square plus x raised to 4 value becomes 1 minus x square plus x, these two term cancel, you get 1 upon 1 plus x square plus x square, remaining term x square upon 1 plus x square into 1 minus x square plus x raised to 4. This x square as it is, I will write. Denominator term, it is of the form a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. It is nothing but what? A cube plus b cube again. So a cube plus b cube, 1 plus x raised to 6. 1 plus 1 cube plus x raised to 2 raised to 3. That is x raised to 6. So x raised to 6 can be rewritten as, so x cube raised to 2 can be written as x cube raised to 2, because x cube derivative is 3x square. So let us rearrange this term, multiply and divided by 3. Now it is of the form f dash of x upon f of x. So integration of 1 upon 1 plus x square is tan inverse x plus 1 by 3 as it is. It is a tan inverse of, if you substitute x cube equals to t, you get 3x square into dt upon 1 plus t square. That is what? Integration of 1 upon 1 plus t, again 1 plus t square. Integration of 1 upon 1 plus t square is tan inverse of t. T value is x cube. Tan inverse of x cube plus c. So this is required answer. Therefore, option A is correct. Next question. Question number 51. They asked to find maximum value. Maximum value of log base x base e divided by x. X is greater than 0. They asked to find maximum value. So using first derivative test, we can determine maximum value as well as minimum value. So find the first derivative. What are the steps? You have to determine y dash. Later you have to equate into 0. You'll get critical points. After that, substitute in given function, you'll get a maximum value as well as minimum value. So differentiate with respect to x, you'll get y dash equals to u by v root x square. X as it is, derivative of x, log x is 1 by x. So x into 1 by x value is 1, 1 minus log x as it is, derivative of x is 1. Now equate it into 0. So y dash equals to 0, 1 minus log x upon x square equals to 0. It implies 1 minus log x equals to 0, or x equals to e. X value is e. So if x is e, then substitute in y value. We'll get y equals to log base e, log e base e upon e. Log e base e value is 1, therefore 1 upon e is correct answer. 1 upon e is correct answer. Therefore, B is correct answer. B is answer. Next one, question number 52. Question number 52. It is based on, again, integration. Integration of e raised to sine x into sine 2x. There are different formula to evaluate the integration of e raised to sine x into sine 2x dx. We have standard formula e raised to ax into sine bx plus c. Or using Eilert rule also, you can determine this value. So before going to apply Eilert rule, I will rewrite the given integration as e raised to sine x. Sine 2x value is 2 times of sine x into cos x. standard formula, sine to x formula. Later I will take a sine x equals to t. If sine x equals to t, dx value becomes cos. So e raised to, taking here x equals to t equals to sine x, dt equals to sine x derivative, cos x into dx. So e raised to, it becomes e raised to t, integration of e raised to t, 2 is constant, sine x value is t, cos x dx value is dt. Now it is of the form u into v form. Using Hylett rule, exponential function, algebraic function, Hylett rule. So 2 as it is. So here t is the first function, e raised to t is second function. First function as it is, t into integration of second function, e raised to t, minus integration of second function, that is e raised to t, derivative of first function is 1, so that is d. Or you can say 2 into t into e raised to t minus integration of e raised to t is again e raised to t plus. So what is the common here? E raised to t common. So 2 into e raised to t into t minus 1 plus. Or your t value is sine x. Therefore it becomes e raised to sine x into sine x minus 1. Plus c is correct answer. E raised to 2 times e raised to sine x into sine x minus 1 is correct answer. Therefore, d is correct answer. Next question. 53. The value of minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2 cos inverse x. Cos inverse x, inverse function. So you have to apply again Hylett rule. Using Hylett rule, we have to determine inverse function integration. Cos inverse can be rewritten as minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2, 1 into cos inverse x. Inverse function is the first function, therefore it is first function, 1 is second function. First function as it is, cos inverse x as it is, integration of second function, that is 1 integration is x, minus integration of second function, that is x, derivative of first function, cos inverse x derivative, minus 1 upon under root of 1 minus x squared into dx. Or x times, your limits are minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2. X times cos inverse x minus 1 by 2 to 1 by 2 minus your derivative of 1 minus x square is minus 2x. Therefore, we can rewrite this term as small adjustment, 1 by 2 multiplying divided by 2, here minus 2x upon root of 1 minus x squared dx, f dash of x upon root f of x. It is nothing but here roots minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, x cos inverse x minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 as it is. Integration of minus 2x upon root of 1 minus x squared. It is of the form f dash of x upon root f of x. It is 2 times of root f of x. Integration value is 2 times of root f of x. Root f of x value is 1 minus x squared. Minus 1 by 2 to plus 1. Here 2 to cancel. Now apply limits.